Ashka, how are you guys? Welcome to my channel. Well, today is a good day. Right now it's 17 degrees centigrade, so it's cold even though it's just August. So today I have decided to do a campus tour with me. There is Shagun and Avika who is recording the video. Right now where we are, it's called Oblastna. So this department over here is called Gynecology Department, and over on this side there are a lot of departments, like the main hospital is in this side, like there's infectious department, pathology and all those things. So since we are not going on this side because when we are going to have classes in 6th year, so we are going to see this side of the like campus. So we are not going this side today. We are going on the other side where we have classes like anatomy and biochemistry, and we are going to go to the dean office where there are classes for Latin, and then also we are going to go for physics, which is on the Kublansky Street, and then we'll come back to med bio and back to the hostel. So let's go. Well, over here is the pediatrics department. We used to have classes here in 3rd year, and this is the hospital for gyno, obstetrics and gynecology. We used to have lectures on like 4th and 3rd floor, and we didn't have classes here because ours was odd group at that time, but like there are times when odd groups have different teachers and the classes are other places, and even group have classes somewhere else, so it was like that. And I will just show you from the rear camera. We used to have classes. We used to go from this gate actually. Soon we'll have classes again. We used to have class on second floor, and I'll just show you this place from the back. See, so there's Avika and Shagun, and this is the whole department. If you're confused about what department, like what building is for which department, so I will just show you. Here, right over here, it's written Department of Pediatrics, Neonatology and Perinatal Medicine, and above, like it's written Bukovinske Državne Medicine Universitet, meaning, so here it's written the name of like the subjects which are taught here, and also like these are the hospitals. So we have classes from 3rd, 4th year over here. So classes in hospital. So if you're sick, so you will be admitted here. Like if you're 17 years old, so they strictly like follow those rules, where if you're under 18, so they will admit you in pediatrics department. And if you have your gyno problems, so come here, you will find teachers over here, they will help you with your problems. Since I was in medical committee, I still am. I used to take students, like girls, over here for their problems in gynecology. Yeah. Right over here is kind of a map where you can see like MRT is MRI, and there's analysis, means where you can get the analysis done and all those things, so you can go wherever you want. It says Miska Dityachna Klinichna Likana, means State Children's Clinical Hospital, and Apteka means pharmacy. So we live with the Ukrainians only, and we go to the same hospitals Ukrainian go to, and all those things. I'll just show you. See, so the hospital Oblastna, it starts. This is the boundary for the hospital actually. So it goes all the way from here to over there, and all the classes of pathology, surgery, ophthalmology, internal medicine we have here. There is urology on another department. There is infectious disease over here. I will show you those things when we'll have classes. In 6th year, they're saying that we'll have classes in almost a week from now. Again, from 1st September, we'll have classes. So it's kind of exciting and sad also that we'll have to go to classes, because we'll have to wake up every single day in 7 a.m. and go to classes, attend classes and everything. We used to have our anatomy and clinical anatomy over here. classes of first year and second year, second sem. So yeah, it was a long time ago. I've come after such a long time, and it was amazing. This is a beautiful place and a beautiful building. Medical informatics and histology lecture right over there. This Bluebird Cafe is highly recommended. Definitely visit. These are my friends. He's Hello. Sanket. He just came from India. He's Junaid. You already know him. There's Vanessa. And sorry, I don't know him. Chelsea. So we were walking and we met my friend. So since we are in hurry, so we are going to leave these guys. Bye-bye. Biochem department is on that side, but we are going this side for physics. We are going to the very famous Koblanska Street. We used to have our physics there, and we used to have histology over there, hygiene also over there. So we are going over there. I'm sure you've heard about the architecture of Europe. It's so ancient. You must appreciate the buildings and everything, and they keep renovating these things to maintain them and everything. Europe, definitely pay attention to the buildings. They are so good. Architecture is definitely one of the most amazing things that attracts the tourists. Chernivtsi is not so old, but obviously if you go to Kyiv, Odessa, Lviv, these places have so much older architecture, so definitely visit. You know this place, I'll just show you again. This. So we used to have our classes over here, this department right over here. I am not sure if you can see, but yeah. So here it's written over there on top. I'll just show from rear. It's written Bukovinsky, Državne Medicinske Universitet. This right over here is biblioteca, which means library, and you can go over here anytime you want. You just need to get yourself a student card and you can visit this place anytime you want, like obviously according to the hours they have. I don't know that because I've never been here. I just prefer studying in my room. We are getting ourselves some coffee. Is actually a movie theater. This is our favorite place for ice cream. Well, this over here is the dean office, and we used to have Latin classes over here, and we used to come here mainly for like our documentation and most of those things. And they also have some ceremonies over here where they give students certificate. I got one like for being a part of medical committee. That was in like fourth year, so that's when I came here. Otherwise we usually don't come here. So we are over here, this Tetralna Square, this building. This is where we used to have our Ukrainian classes and philosophy classes. And there was one more, I guess, culture of Ukraine and history of Ukraine, like those classes in first year. We are going from here to the biochem department, and there is a place where we used to have breakfast and lunch kind of when we used to have classes, because we used to be hungry during the classes, so we used to eat here. There is a small cafe kind of thing, so I'll just show you. I guess it might have changed in so many years, so I guess this was the one, but yeah, it's not open anymore. Or maybe it was this one, we don't know. It's like you have to go downstairs. These are actually apples. Since Ukraine is a cold country, so apples, roses, cherries are very common over here. You'll find them on lots of places. You're crossing the roads. Always cross the roads from zebra crossing, because this is not India and you need to cross your roads. You need to cross the roads from zebra crossing. Otherwise, if you get hurt, it won't be the fault of the driver, it will be your fault. So over here we used to have our biochemistry. So this is our biochemistry department. We used to have biochemistry here. We used to have physiology, pathophysiology, and pharmacology over here. And there is library over here. You don't need a student card. You just you can study here. You can even borrow books from over here. And we used to have med chemistry on 5th floor over there somewhere. And what else we used to have over here? Microbiology over here, immunology, like all these, they have department. There's biochemistry over here, microbiology, pharmacology over there, pathophysiology and physiology somewhere over here. So yeah, we used to have most of our classes in third year over here. Well, it's going to get dark quite soon, so I'm going to end this video over here. Well, the purpose of this video was that I wanted to show that there is kind of like no campus, like there is no boundary over, like in which there are, like there is the university is spread out in the whole city. So we're in, like in whole city Chennai, wherever you see buildings with such marks where it's written like Gokulvinayan State Medical University, so meaning that building is a part of our university. So in those places you will either have classes or they are the hospitals. There are a lot of other buildings, but obviously I couldn't show you all the buildings because there are a lot of buildings I haven't even been to, because of, I told you, like there is odd even kind of thing. So some people have classes somewhere else, some people have classes somewhere else, we have different teachers, so that's why. And some buildings, like the purpose was that I just wanted to show you that these are the main distant buildings. Other all buildings are situated in between this area only. I will show you in the map somewhere wherever I went and how much kilometers I did. Maybe I will include that in this video. And what I wanted to say, that sometimes people think that it's kind of like a trouble that we don't have a campus, that we have to walk such far, but I think that as a person who would want to remain healthy, it's good that you can actually walk this much while even going to the classes. Yes, it can be a nuisance while you have to just reach the class in very few minutes, but yes, it's good health wise. You will get to walk some distance while you're going to classes, so that way it's good. Otherwise we just stay in a room, and me, someone who doesn't go to the gym very often, so it's good for me at least that you can remain healthy, you walk this much distance and everything, etc, etc. So well, that's all for this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you found this video helpful in any way, then give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more videos. And you can leave me your feedback and questions in the comment section below, or you can contact me by Instagram or Gmail. Both of those are given in the description box below as well. Thank you again, and I will see you guys soon in another video. Until then, bye, take care, and have a good day.